Hello, my name is Charles Chip Heyman, and I am Principal Oboe of Canada's National Arts Centre Orchestra. Tonight, I am honored to be your guest host for the NACO home delivery. Je suis ravi d'annoncer le programme musical ce soir pour la livraison à domicile de l'Orchestre du Centre National des Arts. Chaque semaine, nous cherchons dans les archives afin de trouver les programmes stimulants à travers les 50 années de musique au CNA. Tonight, we pay tribute to former music director Pincus Zukerman, whose birthday is tomorrow, July 16th. In any orchestra, a music director not only conducts concerts, but brings to his or her leadership post an artistic personality, repertoire ideas, a vision for the orchestra. The finest conductors are even able to shape the sound and style of the orchestra over time in very clear ways. This was certainly true of Maestro Zukerman, a legendary artist with a strong and specific musical point of view. Notre concert de ce soir met en vedette deux aspects de son travail avec nous dans les premières années à la direction artistique de l'orchestre. The first selection we have for you is Mozart's Third Violin Concerto in G Major, Kirchhoff 216, with the maestro himself as soloist. This recording is from a tour concert we played in the year 2000 in Paris at the Théâtre des Champs-Élysées. During the first few years of our work together, Maestro Zukerman used the orchestra's traditional repertoire from the classical and early romantic eras to establish a common language, with sound, style, phrasing. But in doing this, he also brought to us a kind of flexibility and freedom in performances. And one way he achieves this was in what we call play conducting, where he was concerto soloist and simultaneously conducting lightly from the violin. So this is one such concert. And in these types of performances, not only did we need to match the soloist's musical ideas, but our responsiveness was sharpened. So I like to think of it as doing an already difficult task with the extra challenge of standing on one foot. And in this kind of work together, our ensemble muscles were flexed each time we played a work, no matter how familiar and no matter how many times we had done it, because it would never be exactly the same two nights in a row. So he was facing away from us. Most of the time, all we really had was his sound and the bow to guide us. But I have to say, it would always be superlative. And any NACO musician will tell you that whenever this artist has a violin in his hand, it's always a masterclass, no matter what instrument you happen to be playing. The second work on tonight's concert shows a different aspect of our collaboration with Maestro Zukerman in the early 2000s. Once our common language was well established, we began to explore new repertoire together that called for an expanded orchestra and a fuller, more symphonic approach to sound and style. One memorable example was the epic Bruckner Seventh Symphony, which we performed together in 2002. And that's the second selection on tonight's program. Through the works of Bruckner, Berlioz, Shostakovich, and others, NACO gradually became known as an orchestra that was skilled in music, really from every era. And it really set the foundation for a much more diverse approach to programming and the ability for us as an ensemble to be as nimble as we always were, but with a greatly expanded palette of colors to paint from. And now, one last thought before the concert begins, and this one on a personal note. I'd like to wish my musical mentor and friend, bonne fête, happy birthday, and mazel tov. My dear Pincus, here's to many wonderful memories and many more years of musical friendship. And to all of you, our audience, please enjoy the concert. Bon concert. We look forward to seeing you all when we are able to be together again. We miss you. A bientôt.